Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by William Holland, the Chief Executive of Europa Oil and Gas. Will, very good to speak with you again.
It's good to be back, Stephen.
So you're on with your interim results to end January today. It looks like it's been a very eventful period for the company. Take us through some of the highlights.
It has indeed. It's been a very busy period. I mean, the biggest news I think is our entry into Equatorial Guinea, which is us going into a new territory. It's something which we've been looking at for a year, trying to find the right opportunity. And with this EGO8 asset, I mean, I couldn't have asked for a better deal as our first deal in the Gulf of Guinea area. It's a great jurisdiction to be operating in. We've been welcomed with open arms. We have great access into the government and the regulator there. We've got a very good partner that we're working with, a team that we've worked with before. And most importantly, we've got a really good asset. It's a lookalike asset to the Chevron operated field to the south of us. It's only 9 kilometers away. It's a lookalike field, great seismic response called a class two AVO anomaly. And in this region, when these responses have been drilled, all of the eight exploration wells in this region have all found gas. Of that, seven of them have been commercial successes. So, statistically, this is a really good opportunity. It's exploration, but it's near field infrastructure-led exploration with a very good chance of success. So I'm very excited by that deal.
I mean, and as you say, I mean, it's a groundbreaking deal, drill-ready joint venture. Take us through the progress and the next steps then in Equatorial Guinea.
We acquired the data, so we've got the data. We've done a quality assessment of the data. We think it's excellent. It is what we thought it was going to be. But there were some deeper horizons which hadn't been properly examined. So we've now gone through a system called a paleoscan, where we examine the lower horizons to see if there's any additional prospectivity. We think we found some, and we'll be announcing the additional prospectivity in due course. We wanted to make sure we understood that before we started farming this out. We do need to farm it down. We're looking for a partner to carry us through an exploration well. And we haven't started that process yet. We'll start that process once we fully understand the size of the prize. But interestingly enough, people have noticed, very good partners, potential partners have noticed what we're doing, and we're being approached by large oil and gas companies who want to look at this opportunity because they like it. So it's great. We're very, very pleased, and we'll hope to announce something later on in this year if we can secure a good farming partner.
Another exciting development, Will, was the extension of the license around NHK West offshore Ireland. So more good news for the company as well.
Yes, exactly. I mean, we applied for a 2-year extension. We received the 2-year extension. Minister Eamon Ryan granted that. It was very interesting, actually, because he was asked in a press conference by the Irish Business Post a few days after he granted our extension why he'd done that, because he's a green minister, and he was said, "Well, why have you extended this oil and gas license?" And he basically said, "Well, it's a valid license. They made a valid application, and we honour our contracts. We have a contract in Ireland to explore, appraise, develop, produce NHK West, and the Irish government honours that. So we're now looking for a partner there as well to carry us through the exploration drilling of NHK West."
Hey, can you update us on your offshore UK operations? So the progress with the potential development of the Serenity field in the North Sea.
Yeah, Serenity is ongoing. We're looking at monetization options there. There are a couple of options. We're engaging with the NSTA on that as well. Unfortunately, the NSTA are quite busy with the 33rd round, and they want to complete issuing the licenses under the 33rd round before they're going to properly engage with us. We are in a dialogue with them. It's just difficult to get the bandwidth that we need at the moment. So that's ongoing.
And then onshore UK wrestled with some temporary downtime, and that impacted revenue for the first half. But as you point out in the RNS today, strong balance sheet, and you're still generating good cash flow from your UK assets.
That's right. Yeah, the Wressle well field was shut down for 3 months whilst we were sourcing and installing a jet pump. That's now back online, and over the last quarter, with the gross production there has been very robust. It's sort of at 530 barrels a day, and we've got a two well development program there at Wressle, where we're targeting the Penison Flags, which has just got under 2 million barrels of oil in it. So that's subject to, we're still looking for regulatory approval. It takes a bit of time in the UK to get these approvals, but hopefully with the following wind, we'll get these this development program kicked off this year.
Anything else from the first half you'd like to highlight, Will?
Well, I think it's going to be a very interesting period for Europa. We've also got our onshore Cloughton field, where I hope we'll be able to announce that we've secured a pad in the coming weeks. We've found a good pad location. We found a couple of good pad locations, and I think we're about to secure one. You don't know until the ink is dry, but we should be able to announce that hopefully in the coming weeks, and then we'll be looking to do some seismic followed by drilling a well, hopefully early next year. So there's some really interesting activity there. That's 192 BCF of gas in place near infrastructure onshore UK. So cheap to drill, quick to bring online, no impurities, easy processing onshore UK gas. So it's all in line with the sort of net zero goals, and could be a really big value driver for the company as well.
A couple of months into the second half already, and Will, how's the full year going to pan out?
Well, as I said, there's a good amount of activity across all of our assets with Cloughton, I've just mentioned, also with Wressle as we get those the approvals we need to start that development program. But EG, I think we're going to see some news on EG this year. I think it's a very exciting opportunity, and also 419. There is one other thing that I should mention actually, before we go. We have appointed two new directors over the last period as well, in Simon Ashby-Rudd and Eleanor Rowley. Simon is a great strategist. He's an oil and gas financier strategist, been doing Africa, Europe for his entire career. We're very pleased to have him on board. And then very recently, Eleanor, Dr. Rowley joined us. She's Cambridge PhD, top drawer geoscientist, very, very high caliber individual. Brings the board back to a majority of independence, so strong governance back at Europa.
Sounds like a positive time all round. Will, thank you very much for the updates. I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress.
Will do. Thanks very much, Stephen.
That's William Holland, the Chief Executive of Europa Oil and Gas.